I'm Charlotte and I'm a singer-songwriter and I live in Golden Bay. I'm 47 years old and I've been playing music for 20 years. But I think self-confidence really has held me back from really, I guess, pushing myself out there more to the world. What is it now? It's February. I'm going to share February, what that means for me musically and a bit more of life, and just see how that feels. Till the power came on in 43. Kia ora, I'm Charlotte Squire. I'm a singer-songwriter. I write heaps of original songs and I also sing some covers and I do an interactive show called Together, and I'm coming to you soon, Ruby Bay Tea Rooms community, and I'm going to be playing an interactive show where I invite you to become part of the show. Da 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 da. One more time. Oh, keep going though, keep going. Dum. Da 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 da. And sing some really easy parts, maybe do a bit of percussion. You don't need lyrics or anything. You can just join in a super relaxed and friendly kind of way. And the whole aim of this is to build connection within the audience. So I'd love to see you at my show Together. I'm Charlotte Squire and I will be there. When will I be there? Saturday, February 17th at the Ruby Bay Tea Rooms and Theatre. Yep.
What would I do without your smart mouth drawing me in and you kicking me out? You've got my head spinning, no kidding.
Say that again.
Yes, it's so hot.
Such mistakes, they're much too easy.
Going to record this moment. I don't know if I'm going to put this in the video or not, but I just came home from our gig at Molly B's, had a shower, and I used my lovely strawberry shower gel and my orange toothpaste from Solid Toothpaste, and I feel so clean. Got all the sweat off from playing music, and I'm just coming down from that right now. I'm buzzing, and had a glass of wine. I don't drink that much alcohol, and that'll have me buzzing. And I hadn't eaten that much food all day, and I'm just buzzing with that feeling of preparing for this gig all week, sort of energetically, and now throwing a whole bunch of energy out to a lot of people. There were a lot of people there. The warm-up was slow, took time to warm the crowd up, and I find that really hard. Like, my ideal reality would be we have someone warm up the crowd for us, you know, because we warm them up, and it took a while. I find it quite hard when we play music and the audience don't respond straight away, like in a really overt way, you know, like they don't immediately go woo or start dancing to our music. But yet there were like at least four groups of friends who were there for our band distributed around, and that there were loads more people that we knew we packed that place out tonight, which was actually a little bit overwhelming. It's a busy place anyway, but we definitely made it much busier, which is awesome. But now I know that I just need to let the dust settle and rest and recover, have a good night's sleep, and have lots of water to drink, and so I don't get hungover. But I'm still coming down from that big energetic thing that I just threw out all this energy as a lead singer to a crowd of people to get them into this place with us. And they did, in the end, join us in that, meet us in that really fun place and dance and go wild and have a really fun time with us. But yeah, took a while to get there, and the journey as we were warming the audience up for me involved me sternly occasionally saying I've got this, I can do this, I'm good at this.
Hey there, it's Friday morning, and I've got a show coming up this Saturday night. Into that, it's the camera there, and the Ruby Bay Tea Rooms. I just love the name of the Ruby Bay Tea Rooms, don't you just think cup of tea? I'm just reflecting upon how I felt this week, which is quite tired, and I really often think about my friend Tina Bridgman, who once taught me that when we've got a show or a gig coming up, often we are tired because it's like a tsunami. It's like our inner tide withdraws. We withdraw into ourselves to get ready to blast a whole lot of energy out of the show. And she talks about giving yourself permission to rest and just allow yourself to feel what you feel and to honour those feelings and take care of yourself. And that's what I've been feeling like all week. I've just wanted to just take it really gently. And so I have done that. But I definitely have this nagging sort of, feeling in myself that I need to be pushing myself harder and doing more. And I would have liked to have got more exercise. It's just the juggle with family and work and stuff. But I just wanted to talk about that with you because I think it's something for performers to be aware of, for those who struggle with feeling tired before a gig or a show. That's the process that I go through, and I know Tina goes through it. And so looking forward to driving over the hill on Saturday and playing music at this gorgeous looking venue, and I don't know what it's going to be like, and I'm nervous to go somewhere new. So going somewhere new is scary for me. But once I've been there once, it won't be somewhere new. So
I'm at the Fraser's Orchard, and I just got my bags of fruit. So many yummy things of fruit. I've got plums and peaches and pears and some corn for Marty and some fruit for my pregnant sister. And I've got the show at Ruby Bay later on this afternoon. And as my friend suggested, I'm enjoying spaciousness and solitude. Playing at Ruby Bay. Whew, mama! I'm just coming down off it. I'm on the Takaka Hill. I'm tired and it's 10:30 and a police car just drove past. It's very reassuring. So it was good. There were 10 people there. Some of them were hilarious. I just wanted to say that and say hello from here on the Takaka Hill. Now I'm going to bike. I'm right on the top of the hill. I'm not going to bike. I'm going to drive down the other side of the hill and down into Takaka. Okay, bye. Oh, that's okay. I'm on the Takaka Hill. I'm trying to get some good video. It's not happening. Okay, then. Bye. Huh?